Everything's gonna be alright. Amen. If you don't mind, on this Saturday afternoon, let's bless God, amen, for this great woman of God. Amen. I believe, y'all, we can do a little bit better than that. Let's give God a hand of praise for the life and the legacy of this people. Amen. God truly is a good God. Amen. Especially in times as these. Amen. We need to know that the God we serve is still faithful. He's still just. And he's still a good God. Amen. Amen. We're getting ready now to commence and going into our order of service. Amen. First, we're going to change it just a hair by having the prayer by Bishop Jordan, followed by the Old Testament by Deacon Ralph Copeland, New Testament by Deacon Alpha Reed, solo by Brother Kevin Edwards, but most importantly, yo, let's let God have his way. Songwriter say this may be the last time. I don't know. Let's give God what's due to him. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Bishop Jordan.
We need the old. We need thee. I'm praying already. This time, in this space, in this place, just to say thank you.
Thank you
for how you kept us another day.
Yes.
Thank you for how you woke us up this morning.
Thank you,
Lord, because we may have aches and pains, but God, you woke us up.
Yes.
Thank you, God, we may, God, have issues, but we thank you for being clothed in our right mind. Thank you, God, because you sent your son, Yahshua, Jesus, God, to die on a cross. Thank you because he was buried. Most of all, thank you that he got up. Now, Father, that we have thank you, we ask you, oh God, to touch this family.
Yeah.
God, only my Savior, only you know what they're going through, God. Only, God, you can comfort them, God, in the midnight hour.
Yeah.
God, only you can speak words of peace, oh God.
Yeah.
And we know you right now to be Jehovah Shalom. You are the God of peace, oh God. So we ask you, oh God, to minister to them. Ruach Kodesh, Spirit which is holy, God, come alongside and comfort them, oh God. God, comfort them, God, today, tomorrow, God, and in the future. God, undergird them as only you can. And we will say thank you. Thank you because you are yet God. Thank you because there's no one like you. Thank you because you are yet holy. And we give you honor because you are our Savior. And we say thank you. And we say thank you very much. God, touch everything that shall go on in this service, oh God. God, after everything has been said and done, God, we ask you to go back with them, oh God. Minister to them, oh God. When they lay down overnight at night, God. When they have memories, oh God. Comfort them, God. Let them feel your arms of protection. Let them feel your warmth of love. And we give you honor, we give you honor, we give you glory. In your son Yahshua's name, we decree it to be so. And let every heart say amen.
Amen.
This morning, our scripture will be coming from Job chapter 19.
Amen.
For I know that my render lives, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth, and through after my skin worn, destroyed this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another through my ring be consumed within me. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The New Testament scripture coming from John
11, verses 24 through 27. Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? She said unto him, Yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, which should come into the world. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. I see Brother Kevin Evans. Amen. Let's give him a hand as he comes forward. Amen.
Amen. Let our say amen.
Amen.
Amen again.
Amen.
One more time for the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen. We ought to give God some praise in this house this morning. Oh, come on, y'all can do better. Let's give God some praise in this house. Amen. Thank God for being here. Amen. Thank God for the family. Family I've been knowing a long time. Amen. Thank God for the recording. Tisha for asking me to come sing. And glad to be here on today.
Amen.
But how many of y'all know this morning that he's a lily in the valley? Oh, don't fool me now. How many know he's a lily in the valley? And he shines bright as a morning star. Choir, y'all don't mind. Y'all have been saying this song. Song says, there's a lily, my Lord, in the valley. Find out that it's bright as the morning star. There is a lily, lily. It's in the valley, shining bright as the morning. It's a day, it's a lily. It's in the valley, shining bright as the morning star. And amen, amen, oh Lord, amen. So yes, it's a day, it's a lily. It's in the valley, find out that it's bright as the morning. Somebody put their hands together, say, there is a lily, lily, it's in the valley shining, yeah, yeah. I say, there is a lily, lily, it's in the valley shining bright as the morning star. I say, amen, I say, amen. Yeah, it just stopped right there, y'all. I said, there is joy. It was in the valley. Find out that it's bright as. Somebody wave your hand this morning. I said, there is joy. Joy. It's in the valley, shining bright as the moon. Yeah. I said, there is joy. Joy. Star. I say amen, say amen, say oh Lord, amen. It's another thing, y'all. I said there is peace. It was in the valley, find out that it's bright as the morning. This my voice say there is peace. It's in the valley, shining bright. Yeah, oh yeah. I say there is peace, peace in the valley, shining bright as the morning star. I say amen, say amen, I say amen. It's another thing, one more thing. I say there is love, yeah, it's in the valley. Find out that it's bright as the morning. Yeah, there is love, love. It's in
Yeah. catch on to the word. That's all time. We hide all the dressing up, whatever we could get, the cold shoes and everything, cars and stuff. But it fell back down. It fell back to the main thing. Our daddy used to make us walk the church. If we miss it, we got to look at it. But the main thing, when we walk the church, we got something out of because we had a community of a family.
Yeah, yeah.
And they give us a ride every now and then. But the main thing about all of this, y'all, God will bring you regardless of what. But don't stand still and wait for a flesh to bring you. Get the word.
All right.
Get the word and read it. Read it just like it's, just read it just like you're eating candy cookies. I like Brother Bridget. Read it just like you eat Brother Bridget.
Yeah.
But Brother Honey, I appreciate you for being part of my sister's life. And y'all are church now.
Amen.
And I thank y'all.
Amen.
Then she changed her mind. Then next year, come the next Sunday, she said, you know what? I think I'm about ready. I mean, she had it in pieces. She didn't just do it. Now I told her, I said, Lightning, you pray and ask the Lord if he's ready for you to join. She said, Pam, you know what? I'm going to do that. She said, I love you for looking after me and trying to help me, guide me. I said, I can talk with you. But you the one got to make up your mind. I can't say lie to make you up. And she said, the next Sunday she came, she said, you know what, Clem, she hugged me, she says, I'm going to join. She said, I begin to like church. I really like church, and I do believe she really had got into church, you know.
Amen.
And she has enjoyed it. And she would tell me, call me, way before she got ready to come, she says, I got to wait till my daughter get here now. I can't come now right away, she said, but I will be there at the Lord willing. And when Tisa bring her, her daughter bring her and put out, she says, don't, I said, who is that? She said, this me, sis. Let me in, I'm ready to go to church. Are you ready? And I told her, I said, I'm not quite ready, you know, just yet. She says, but get on whatever you got to get on, because I'm going to leave you if you don't come. And she did. I mean, she was kind of shy, but she didn't talk much. But you let someone wrong. You wouldn't have to ask her. You'd be some help for y'all. But she did not, you know, put up with just anything. I mean, when she got, you know, the baby to come to church, before I could walk in my door, the phone rang. Right? I said, I know that is. And my husband said, let me answer. He said, oh. It's Lottie Mae, and first thing she had, she said, what pastor ain't preached on today? And you know, I tell her, she said, wait a minute, let me get my opinion, I gotta write this down. And she said, I just got to write it, and I'll read it later. And I said, okay, and she'll keep talking, and she, next thing she'll say, what do you wear to church today? What color? Okay, I wore blue or something. She says, Clem, girl, you know what? You just dress wonderful. She said, that's how I got started dressing like you. I said, well, you didn't have to dress like me. You had your own mind, you know, people. She said, no. She said, when they tell you, oh, here come Miss Providence. She said, I just went, wow. She said, I want to get me Miss Providence. I said, I'm not Miss Providence. I said, I come to church to serve the Lord just like you. But she was sweet and kind, and I loved her for every step moment. And I'm so proud that the Lord gave us to us. And we were the family. We rolled up together. Half of us was back up there, maybe Mama too. But our oldest sister there was the mama over us. But the rest of us, we hold one another.
Yes.
Like my other sister said, she could walk and cheer it. We had it. It was like, I say, I'm not calling anyone. We were like cows. We were just a whole, we had the water cover.
Yeah.
And we did not dare not to go, because if we did, like she said, Dad would let us, you know, give us understanding. We didn't want that, but we enjoyed going to church. We enjoyed, you know, family. We enjoyed now. We weren't no rich people. We weren't no fancy people. We were just ordinary people trying to learn about the Lord.
Yeah.
And we did learn how to Lord. We got in the choir, we started singing. We got, you know, doing things for the church, it's different things. But like I said, Lottie Mae was, she was, I love all my sisters and all of them the same thing. She was my heart. We grew together. At the time I spent with her, when she started coming to church, we were just like one. And she would tell me, she says, what are you going to cook today? I mean, here was a little thing she was always making. And I tell her, she says, oh, wait, I should stay and eat dinner with you and, you know, kind of like that. And, but I love her and I care for her and I want her to be all right and everything. Then she told me one time, she said, you know what? We need to get more closer as a family. We need that. Help one another to do what we can for one another. So I love her, no matter what it was, but she was just my heart, and I love her. And I'm gonna miss her, but I know the Lord knows me. And I'm, you know, we just got to be strong, hold up, care one another, do whatever we can, help one another. So I thank the Lord for it. I thank the time we had spent with her, and all this, I knew we're gonna miss her. But she's in a better place than she is. Mom, no aches and pains, no crying, no suffering. She in a better place. So let us pray for each and every one of us, and let's hope that Lord will do us. Let all of us be good and help one another. Pastor Ann, like she said, I love you too. You were good at lighting me while we're here. Don't you forget, we find out what Pastor Ann preach on. And I said, I'm not going to get right here. And sometimes I don't get, you know, fight it down. I said, oh, God, I got to remember what it matters. But she will remind me, if you don't get it, you better tell me what it said. You know, I already get it. And she loved Pastor Ann too. She said, Pastor Ann holds her and moves her a lot. So each and every one of you all, bless the family, and we thank each and every one of y'all, each and every one of y'all, and y'all just give us praise and glory. That's all we ask. And we're not begging, we just asking y'all to pray for our family and uphold us. And I love each and every one of y'all. Thank you.
Georgia one day, and a man pulled up there I knew that canned squash to the market. He said, get a box of them squash up for that truck. Well, I can't cook. What am I going to do with a box of squash? So I talked to my sister, and she didn't, at the time she couldn't cook them. I said, I know I can get a lot of them cooking. But, so my sister said, is she going to cook them? I said, yeah. She told me what to get to bring with them, and she'll cook them for you. So I know I didn't, you know, be greedy and go over there and try to get her to cook the whole box. Just take enough over there and get by. But like I say, she was my cook, my phone buddy. We had a lot of laughs and stuff on the phone. And I never met her kids, but she talked about them. I met her the other day, and so I'm going to miss her. My closing, I pray the family that far and near, I pray that y'all have safe travel back to your destination.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good on the pastor, a bit gay. Miss Lyda Miley. Sweet person.
Yeah.
I'm speaking on behalf of we were as classmates, but she's always had that smile she had. She was shy.
Yeah.
You saw her, that's my, and I tell Mayor all the time, dude, all of them look just alike. And I've been in the Miley, Yerby family all my life. So, kids, I'm like y'all uncle. But your mama and my wife, we all grew up together. And a loving family. And I thank God for you all, and I'm praying for you. And I didn't know Lottie was ill like she was, but God knows what best. And you all, she taught you well. So just keep what she taught you in heart, and everything will be all right.
That's right.
I love you all. Thank you.
I just want to say, this family, the Miley family, all my 81 years of my life, the years, and the Miley, more or less family, we was on a sharecropped farm. We come up together on that farm. We had to do the cotton, the corn, the tobacco, peanuts, potatoes, cane, rape yard, holy grain, everything. The Miley's, all of us, ain't had nothing. Nobody had nothing. So one couldn't talk about the other because the other ain't had nothing. We had serpent bread. We was thankful for that. Yeah, we was thankful for the serpent bread and the crackling bread and all like that. Pork skins and like that. We didn't have to come up on the green that we had to eat green for breakfast. That was good. We had to eat peas for breakfast. That was good. Because at the time when we was coming up, it was hard. And y'all knew how the other folks. Didn't give us anything, but we thank God for where he brought us from. And as we can look back and we can say, look where he brought us from. And she has brought us from a mighty long way. So I say to my family, to all of you, we just got to keep looking up from where our help comes from. Don't keep your head down, because ain't nothing down there but rocks and dirt. Keep your head up, because you know where he is at. So as she, as Sister Clement was saying, she loved the Lord and she joined this church. So all of us, we got to go back. If we don't turn around and go back and come back to him, to our first love, because he is our first love. He loved us first. So now it's time for us to return that love back to him. So I said to y'all just keep holding on, because God don't make no mistake, none whatsoever. Thank y'all.
Amen. She never could draw no hopscotch, I bet you that. She couldn't draw no hopscotch. I never had to go to hopscotch.
Definitely, everyone. My name is Patrick. I'm one of the youngest nephews Auntie Lotta May had. But I want you to say something just for Corey teaching. I say, and they can say, all the nephews can say as well, growing up, this is one of the places I wanted to be, at my Auntie Lotta May house. Corey Teach can tell you, weekends, summertimes, oh, I was there. The home-cooked meals, just like the deacon of the church say, oh, good meals, oh, man. I never saw so many incredible meals, just you take whatever you got in the pantry and just make a good meal, and just, at the end of the day, it's probably one of the best moments of my life. A lot of people don't understand the women of the families and everything, especially my Auntie Lotta May, they played a lot of roles. They played the mother, they played the father, they played your, like your uncle. They played every role that possibly a human being that can be in the world to you. And a lot of people look at us as, hey, the women in our family, they hold us together. They want to bring us back. Like I said, I've been gone for years. I was sitting down, thought about all the moments I had Corey and Tisha. Those were some of the best moments of my life. Those were some of the moments when I saw Corey and Tisha, then I knew it went on. Those were moments like I told Corey last night, decided to retire, to get back with family, and actually get those moments back. You never can get back time, but some of the moments you can actually enjoy. Mm-hmm. And I'm telling you, playing out on the basketball goal, y'all being bigger cousins, beating me up, pushing me down. Going right back in the house, Auntie Lotta May get back out there with me. But I would say, Auntie Lotta May, the amount of time that she invested, just not me, but the nephews, the rest of the nieces and stuff, it was all from the heart. Every meal she made, every time. Anybody know how the generation these days are? It's not the same as the older generations. It was well worth it. Every moment I spent on her, learned something. She invested into her nieces and nephews, sisters and everything. But I can say, I know going to the medical, I know she's in a better place. She's resting, she's looking down. Say she raised two wonderful kids, grandkids and everything. And like I say, she probably wouldn't have no other way. If we can repeat life, she'll probably do the same thing again. Take care of anybody that needed a place to move up somewhere to stay. Or just giving them their time. All I say, thank you, Tisha and Cora. Like I say, your mom will never be missed. She'll always be here with us in spirit. Like I say, all those times, best weekend songs, those were the most wonderful times of my life. And I say, do, thank you.
Church. I'm looking at the family. I'm looking at the friends that this young lady generated through life. You know, we all unite here for the final opportunity. To be in the midst. Such a wonderful person. And everybody looking at me, y'all don't even know who I am, do you? Well, I'm Cookie, baby boy. Ethel Bell Miley. Y'all remember her? She left here about 20-something years ago, but life is still good. And because of evolution and life in itself and all of the things that we enjoy, I got to enjoy a cousin that was, sorry, rest of y'all cousins, we were really close. Said he drove a truck. I drove a truck for the last 24 years. And there were many days and nights that she would call me, give me 250, 300 miles down the road, laughing. She loved my mom. She loved my family. All of y'all love my mom. However, at this last day that we get to be in the midst of the share, Harvest, such a wonderful soul, and I want everybody to know we all have souls just like that. We all have impressed somebody's life, and we all have learned to bond. And I see down here in South Georgia, I'm from Florida, but the way you guys support one another and be there for one another, you know, this is a moment in time. Our last day to remember this. And as sweet as she was, shy, like they say, she ain't say much. She sit back and look at you. Evaluate you. And when she told me about the kids, I didn't even know about the kids. I mean, but many years has gone by, and we bonded, and we learned to love and cherish. And the preacher to the preacher that has fed her the spiritual food, congratulations to you. You had an opportunity. And I'm sure everybody in your congregation, strong Christians, little small church in the south part of Georgia, that praise the Lord. Lord, love be praised. Amen. But you know something? I want you to know that this world is not our home.
Amen.
They tell me this. There's a place that God is going to prepare for us.
Thank you.
I love the Lord for just considering me. And every one of us need to love the Lord for considering us. My Lord, he didn't have to let us be here. But he woke us up this morning. How did he wake us up this morning and we were focused on getting here? We wanted to be here with baby girl. We want to be here. I can't believe that this has happened. But guess what? Every man, born or woman has an appointment with this very same. Be careful how you treat the people that surround you. Create a wonderful environment around you. Let the people feel real love. You know, real love hard to find. Whole lot of people playing, whole lot of people saying things that they really don't mean. If you love somebody, let them know you love them. Lord have mercy, let them know you love them. Preacher, I ain't trying to take your time, but 2 minutes. How can I, 67, almost 67 years of life, a year ahead of me, she be like, I'm older than you.
I say,
okay, you got more crust than me. Sorry. Hello, I'm trying to make it to tomorrow. But look here, folks. Funerals are for us who are still here. A couple weeks ago, I could see her walking up to the pearly gates. We hurt because she's gone. God is rejoicing because she's in his presence. That's what they've been teaching me all these years. I'm just a year behind, and I been in the church. And I love the Lord because when I don't have a man, I don't have a friend, I got a friend in him. Like I said, our treasures are in heaven. And I'm glad that I took the time to come up here because La-di-da is very special to me, just like every one of you. You're here for a reason. Because she had an impact on your life. But remember, we're just passing through.
Amen.
May God bless, keep every one of you. Your sicknesses, your health, your finances, your mental state of mind. I'm praying that your bodies be healed. I'm praying that we find a way to financially make it to tomorrow. It gets a little difficult, but we are strong race of people. We have come through tribulations and trials all through our lives. But look at the blessing. When you live a certain way, now everybody don't get to enjoy heaven. Everybody don't get to enjoy the fact that God prepared a place for us. Because the way we live our lives, we care less what we do to people. Let's try to be stronger. Let this day, we'll always remember it. But I love y'all. And I want you guys to know. I'm glad she created kind of unity in this area. In the life, running up and down them roads. I remember them days. We had to come up here every summer. I hated Georgia. I still hate Georgia. I'm sorry. I ain't paying no property taxes. I ain't paying no state taxes. Like, all the extra stuff come with it. But Georgia, I did bad out here. And thank God I didn't have to come up here to the tobacco field and go around. I was young enough, I could play around. But my brothers and sisters, they were out in the field with all of them. They get on the truck and don't come back to late. There it is all get out tired. Well, life is life. Let me see. I just want a word of this song. Just one song. This world is not my home. I am just the passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me round heaven's open door, and I can feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know, oh, I have no friend like you, and if heaven was my home, oh Lord, what would I do? The angels beckon me around heaven's open doors, and I can feel at home in this world anymore.
Amen. Amen. We thank God, amen, for that. Amen. 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 I tell you, amen, Sister Fulton, amen, was a wonderful woman. Amen. We just thank God. Amen. Next, amen, we will have Brother Edwards. We ask that he will come forward. Amen. Then we'll go into the eulogy. See what thus says the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Little heart said amen again. One more time.
Amen.
Amen. I want to dedicate the last song to everybody in this building, especially to the family. Because I can know down through the years, I can imagine Miss Lana made the same down through the years that I've had some good days. I've had some bad days. But I know she can say, still, I won't complain. I want to dedicate this song to everybody. The song say, I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and some lonely nights, but when I look around and All of my good days, outweigh my bad days. I won't complain. You see the clouds hang low, and I can hardly see the road. So I just ask the question, Lord, Lord, why so much pain? But can I get somebody to lift their hands all over this building this morning and say, He knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes, they cannot see. But instead of complaining, I can wave my hands all over this building this morning and say, thank you, Lord. I've been lying, but I thank you, Lord. I've been misunderstood sometimes, but thank you, Lord. I won't complain. I don't know about y'all this morning, but He dressed. But instead of complaining, I can say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. Can I get somebody to get up on their feet right now and say, He's yours. Instead of complaining,
when I look back over my life, y'all, see how far God has brought me. I can fold them all like this. Look toward heaven and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I've been lied on, but thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I've been talked about, but thank you, Lord.
Amen. Is that your story on today? Is that your story on today? Regardless of what all you've been through, I won't complain. And the reason why we won't complain, because we know where our help comes from. He tells us in the word, He said, cast your cares upon me. Amen. He said, for I care for you. Let's give Brother Evans another hand of praise. God is a good God. And He's worthy to be praised. Amen. We thank God for today. Yeah. Because we all have an appointed time. Which means, my brothers and sisters, we got to get our house in order. See, that's what the prophet Isaiah told Hezekiah. He said, thus saith the Lord, He said, set thine house in order. Say, for you shall die and not live. Songwriter Brother Wright said, this is addressing a room down here. He got to go to heaven with y'all. This is a prerequisite. It starts right down here. And I'm going to tell you, amen, He's looking. Y'all don't want to hear me. He's looking to see what happens down here. So we got to live every day just like it's our last day. Amen. We give honor, amen, to Amen, Bishop Jordan. Amen. To the ministers, the deacons, everybody here in your respective places.
Yes, yes, yes.
To this wonderful staff, funeral home head staff. Let's give them a hand. Amen. To this wonderful, loving family. Y'all, let's bless God for them. Sometimes we, and I shared this, I believe, with Sister Thomas. We don't always understand how God works. And if we try to figure it out, we'll just about lose our mind. Because Isaiah said it best. He said, his ways are not our ways. He said his thoughts are not our thoughts. So just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so his thoughts higher than ours. And his ways higher than ours.
Yes.
But he promised to be with you.
Yes.
Regardless of what you go through.
Yes.
And he's still here with you.
Yes.
Right now.
Yes.
We're not going to prolong the time any longer.
Yes.
But God placed the word in my spirit.
Yes.
Amen. I tell you, I'm a mister.
Oh, yes.
But I know, amen, that God does everything for a reason. On this Saturday morning, we're going to go to Matthew. Amen. Matthew, the fifth chapter. Man, if y'all don't have a Bible, y'all can use them on cell phones. Amen. Y'all might as well say so. Everybody can have one. Matthew, the fifth chapter. And we would like to commence reading at the 16th verse.
Yes.
Shine on me. Shine on me. I wonder where. Three words, and that is thank God for the light. Amen. Thank God. Amen for the light. My brothers and sisters, amen, members and friends. In the book of Genesis, we'll start right there. Is that all right? The first chapter, and I believe around the third verse. Amen. The word of God, it tells us that God, he spoke a word. Amen. He said, let there be light. And the Bible say, y'all, that whenever God spoke the word, the Bible saying, then there was light. What a mighty God we serve. And as that verse, y'all, those scriptures began to unfold, he said that he saw that the light was good. Amen. How do you know everything that God makes is good? Amen. You know you're talking about yourself. Let me try it again. How do you know everything that God made is good? And he saw that, amen, it was good. And the Bible said what happened then was that he separated the light. Amen. From the darkness. Amen. There he considered light to be day. Amen. And darkness to be night. Amen. And as I begin to start thinking, my brothers and sisters, amen, about, amen, Sister Fullerton. My brothers and sisters, amen, she was indeed a light. Am I right about it? God, the word that God spoke, amen, many thousands of years ago when he said, let there be light. Whenever y'all look around this sanctuary and look at these windows, amen, you can still see the light coming on in. Am I right about it? Which lets us know that God is not slapped by any means. Amen. If he said it, it will come to pass. Amen. But when I think about the light, my brothers and sisters, Sister Lottie, it seemed like y'all was, my God, just like a few days ago. That Sister Clementine. Amen. And Sister Lottie, y'all, they would come to church. And whenever they would get here, y'all, they would come in, and Sister Lottie, y'all know she didn't talk a whole lot. So she would go and she would talk to just a few people. Now that she mingled just a little bit, she would go ahead and she would sit down. And what she would do then, y'all, she would sit down and she would look back up to the pulpit. And then I know then, Mr. Jordan, when she looked up here, y'all, it's about time to go ahead and start. The deacons know that too, that's why they were there smiling. And she would sit there, y'all, and she wouldn't say, amen, a whole lot. But one thing I believe that the Providence Church family can attest to here today is that we knew she was right here. Am I right about it? And Brother Corey, when I think about Mom, amen, I think about a light.
Yeah. Yes.
See, Brother Corey, whenever you walk into a room and you turn on a light, many times you don't typically hear that light when it comes on.
All right.
But you know it's there. And a lot of times we did not always hear Sister Lottie. Amen. But we knew that she was there. See, my brothers and sisters, God has a way to work through his children. Amen. If we allow it. Word of God said, let your light so shine. It said, before me, and that others may see thy good works, that may glorify our Father, which is in heaven. If y'all don't mind, my brothers and sisters, I want to talk about this light. This light, my brothers and sisters, amen, that is a little different from any other light. This light, my brothers and sisters, is not like these lights that you see up here. Amen, and these Georgia Power, and amen, and Carpool EMC, Florida Power, and Alabama Power. Amen, the only thing that this light needs right here is a belief and a confession. And the reason why I say that, because Romans 10:9 says, if thou confess with thy mouth, he said, believe within thy heart that God has raised him, talking about Jesus. You know, whenever y'all hear that name, there should be some movement going on in your heart. Amen. That raised him from the dead. Amen. He said that thou shalt be saved. This light, my brothers and sisters, is like no other light. This light, my brothers and sisters, amen, he is the word of God. He chose to wrap himself up in flesh. Amen. Chose to come and see about his people for a little while. Y'all know the story. Even when he got here, amen, many did not even want him to be down here. Amen. But he continued to let that light so shine. You see, my brothers and sisters, whatever, you got God on the inside of you. I come to tell you, you have that light. The word of God says, ye are the light of the world. Amen. Say, a city that sits upon a hill. Amen. That cannot be hid. My brothers, when God gets down on the inside, I want you to know that you can't cover him up. Amen. You can't shut him up. When God gets down on the inside, you can't look over him. Amen. You can't look around him. Amen. But you gotta go to him. Amen. I'm talking about when God gets on the inside. Talking about thank God for the light. Thank God. Amen. For the light. One day, my brother said the light that I'm talking about, one day, he went up onto a mountain. Y'all have to forgive. I have to go make God easy. And when he went up on the mountain, he told the disciples, I need you to go across the water. The Bible said he went on up there and began to start praying. Y'all, you ought to be able to go to a place. Y'all don't want to hear me. You ought to be able to go to a place that you're able to pray every now and then. Amen. That you're able to call upon the name of Jesus. You see, because sometimes storms will rise. Amen. And the winds will blow. Amen. But long as God is on the inside, as long as that light is on the inside, y'all know he's stocking him around. He said, behold, I stand at the door. He said, if any man hears my voice, he said, and open the door. And that's the part you play in. He said, then I will come in and I will stop. But you gotta let him in. The door been closed for too long. You gotta let him in. The Bible said when Jesus came down from the mountain, he looked out and he saw, amen, the disciples from far off. When he did that, Bishop Jordan, when he did, he began to start making his way out on the water. There, when they saw him, y'all, they was wondering, is this a ghost? Amen. But I want you to know that when you got the light of God on the inside, you ain't got to be afraid of anybody. But Jesus told him, be not afraid. Amen, for it is Jesus. Peter said, Lord, if you're down, he said, the beard need to come out on the water. Amen. Jesus told him, come on, Peter. And the Bible said that when he stepped out of the boat. You see, that's what's wrong sometimes, y'all. We don't want to step out of the boat. See, sometimes we get comfortable in our own place. Amen. We get comfortable in our own sleep. Amen. But God is saying, amen, and come where Jesus is. The Bible said that when he stepped out of the boat for a minute there, y'all, he was doing real fine. He was doing good, he could read. But whenever he started looking at everything that was around, whenever he started noticing how the waves were moving, whenever he started noticing about everything but keeping his eyes on the light, the Bible said he started to see. But I thank God I serve a God. Amen. And whenever I start to see, amen, there ain't no place low enough where my God can reach down and pull this children out of the water. David said he brought me out of the marble clay. Set my feet, amen, upon a rock. Amen. When God gets on the inside, amen, you don't ever have to worry about the storm. Amen. Peter started seek. But Jesus was right there. Sometimes your feelings, family, your feelings will start to sink. And I come to tell you, Jesus is right there. Amen. He'll lift up the standard of this thing. And Satan gotta go somewhere else. When Jesus is filled up on the inside, Satan gotta get on the outside. Thank God for the light. Amen. Thank God for the light. Not only when we think about it when he went on the water. Yeah. Amen. But more even when we think about when he was out preaching, amen, to a great multitude. Yeah. And then he told them they was getting ready to go off. He said, we can't let them go right now. Yeah. Amen. We can't allow them to go in hunger.
Yeah.
Amen. And he asked one of the men, he said, son, where are we going to find food?
Yeah.
Amen. To feed that people.
Yeah.
Amen. And what happened, one of them told him, he said, there's a lad in the crowd. See, God always got a ring on the bush. He said, there's a lad in the crowd with two fish and five barley loaves of bread. And the Bible says that when they had those two fish and the five barley loaves of bread, what they did to them, amen, when those two fish was they whipped and they gave it to Jesus. Y'all didn't get that. One day Jesus is coming back. One day church, he's coming. The Bible said that they went in with the bridegroom. But the Bible said that five that did not have the oil in the vessel. They were trying to borrow some oil.
Imagine it was getting tough then.
But the Bible said that what happened was that the Lord shut the door. And I don't know about y'all, my brothers and sisters. I don't want God to shut the door. Amen. I want to allow God to be the light on the inside of me. Amen. I want to continue to be that city that sits upon a hill. Amen. That cannot be hid. Talk about thank God. Amen for the light. Amen. Thank God for the light. This light, my brothers and sisters, that amen, well over 2,000 years ago. This light, y'all, he chose to wrap himself up in flesh. Amen. The light, y'all, he turned the word of God, he turned into flesh. Amen. So that we can see the right way to live. Amen. This the light, my brothers and sisters, Jesus, what he did. Amen. As y'all recall, as he began to start moving down, the Bible said that even when he was around 12 years old, amen, he was sharing the light. My brothers and sisters, I want you to know that you're old enough to share the light with somebody else. I love what you said, Mother, because Sister Lottie was sharing the light with you. Amen, and you were sharing the light with her. Somebody say, when all the God's children get together, y'all still don't want to hear it. When all the God's children get together, what a time. This light that I'm talking about, my brother, sister, one day he went down to the pool of Bethesda. Amen. It called the man that was standing there, he couldn't walk. Amen. This light, y'all, he made him walk. This light that I'm talking about, this is one day there was a woman that had an infirmity for 18 years. This light, my brother, he made up be able to stand straight up. Not only that, my brother, this light that I'm talking about, the woman had an issue of blood for 12 years. But he was able to stop that. This light that I'm talking about, my brothers and my sisters. He performed miracle after miracle. He finally knocked robbery within himself. To say, I got to fulfill the prophecy that Isaiah talked about some 700 years before. This light, my brothers and sisters, amen, he was talked about. Amen, he was scorned. Amen, a crown of thorns was placed on his head. Amen. They whoop this light. This light, my brothers, and not only did they whoop him, they put a scarlet rose on his back. Amen. They did everything. They spied on him. Amen. Marched him up the hill.
All right. Oh, yes. Lord.
He allowed himself to be riveted to an old rugged cross. Not come to tell somebody, y'all, he could have came down. But he said one day. Yeah, I know sometimes we don't know things. We may make mistakes and everything, so I got to be first part. One day he knew Hades was going to mess up. So he said, I got to stay right here. Amen. I got to fulfill the promise. Y'all know the story. They pierced him in the side and out came blood and water. Amen. You know the story. Darkness was all over the land. They took him down, placed him, and Joseph on Arimathea's tomb. Stayed there all night, Friday night. Stayed there all night, Saturday night. But early on that third day morning, y'all, that should be your testimony. That should be your testimony. That should be your testimony, because if not, we would have been seeking and seeing. That should be early on that third day morning. He got up with all power in his hands. Power to keep you. In perfect peace. He said, if you keep your mind stayed on, thank God for the light. I was talking very briefly when everything was real fresh to Sister Thomas. I believe she told me that it was Joshua 1:9. Amen. Which tells us, talks about, be strong. Amen. And have courage. And the latter part of that, y'all please hear this. The latter part of that scripture, the latter part, and it tells us, for God will go with thee wherever thou goest. There's no place in this world that our God can't go with his children. There's no valley too low where my God can't pull you out. There is no sea that is too wide that my God can't walk just like he walked to the disciples and take care of your situation. I thank God for the light. Word of God said, let not your heart be troubled. So ye believe in God, believe also in me. He said, for in my Father's house there are many mansions. He said, it was not so. He said, I would have told you. He said, I go away to prepare a place. And if I go away to prepare a place, he said, I will come again. Amen. To receive you to myself. Amen. That where I am, there ye may be also. And he said, the way I go, you know. He said, in the way, you know. Thomas really didn't understand. Lord, therefore, how do we know the way? How do we know that Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father. Let not be God's word for God's people.
Says, because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need. You see, he lets me rest in the meadows grass, and he leads me beside the quiet stream. He restores my failing health, and he helps me to do what honors him the most. And that's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. I'm safe in his arms. Amen. If it does your heart good to know that Sister Lottie Fulton is safe in the arms of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, then please join me in giving her memory a round of applause. Every time. The family is grateful, for they have truly been blessed by your acts of kindness, your loving words, your visits, your food, and your phone calls. But most importantly, they've been blessed by your prayers. See, we believe that prayer will change all things. And the Bible teaches us that the prayer of the righteous availeth much. So if you believe that in your hearts today, we ask that you continue to pray for this family as they continue to pray one for another. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God for the message, and truly we thank God for the messenger. Please join me and giving Pastor Marcus Haynes a round of applause at this time. Pastor Haynes, may God continue to keep and bless you. Amen. Is the Stevens McGee staff prayer. Amen. Amen. For other pulpit guests, Bishop Jordan, we thank God for you on today. May God continue to keep you and bless you as well. Amen. For all other ministers of the gospel that may be in the pulpit, we recognize you today and God bless you and keep you as well. For the deacons of the Providence Missionary Baptist Church, we thank God for you all. Amen. On being attended today, standing in your rightful place for your dear beloved sister. Amen. God bless and keep you always is our prayer. Amen. For the choir singing from their hearts today, we thank God for you. Amen. Any other deacons and ushers in the Providence Church family, we just thank God for you. Amen. And we bid you all Godspeed. For those of us, for those who are joining us via live stream, we thank God for you as well. Amen. And the family does feel your support, and they ask that heaven shine upon you forever. Everyone who made this homegoing service a special one for a special someone, we just cannot say thank you enough, and we bid you all Godspeed. Amen.
Amen.
If you turn with me to the poem
on the inside of the program. It's entitled Our Mother. And I want you to please pay attention to the words of this poem as we read along. Our mother, you can only have one mother, patient, kind, and true. No other friend in all the world will be the same to you. When other friends forsake you, to mother you will return. For all her loving kindness, she asks nothing in return. She asks nothing in return. We need to remember that. Mothers give, give, and give, and ask nothing in return. Amen?
Amen.
As we look upon her picture, sweet memories we will recall of a face so full of sunshine and a smile for one and all. Sweet Jesus, take this message to our dear mother up above. Tell her how we miss her and give her all of our love. This poem comes from Tisha and Corey in memory of their sweet mother, Mrs. Lottie Mae Fulton. Sunrise, August 20th, 1956. Sunset, February 12th, 2024. The candles represent the love, the honor, and the respect we know you hold in your hearts for Miss Lottie. As they're being blown out, we encourage each of you to continue to allow the memories in your heart to burn forever. Because we know from personal experience that memories will heal a broken heart. We present this token of love to Tisha and Corey, and we ask that they treasure the memory of their mom forever and ever. Let your heart say amen.
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 Amen. Let's give the love that they have for their mom a round of applause. We say to the family, we hope and pray that we've been helpful during this time, and maybe we help to erase at least one of your pains. If we've done so, just know that our goal has been accomplished. If you should need us, or if there's anything that any of us can do to make the days ahead a little bit brighter, we're just a phone call away. On behalf of my dad, Mr. Jim McGee Sr., and the entire Stevens McGee Funeral Home staff and family, always remember, family, that earth has no sorrow. We ask that you please join the family for the committal rites, the closing prayer and benediction at the Salem Missionary Baptist Church Cemetery in Barney, Georgia.
Amen.
Following the burial rites, the family will share dinner with members of the family and friends here at the church annex. Once again, we thank you one and all. May God continue to bless you as I pray. At this time, let's prepare our hearts for the final.
We're You can't be.